Unforgettable in every way.
And forevermore.
And forevermore.
That's how you'll stay.
That's how you'll stay.
That's why, darling, it's incredible.
What's incredible is that in 1992, a song over 40 years old would sweep the Grammys, earning 6 awards, including Album, Record, and Song of the Year. And Natalie Cole does incredible justice to over 20 songs on this double album tribute to her dad, the late Nat King Cole, a man whose talent, like this duet, is unforgettable.
I started doing that duet really about 10 years ago, live, with my dad's audio version on a reel-to-reel, and we were kind of experimenting with it. We brought the show, we did like a few songs, we did Love, we did Mona Lisa, we did a few other songs, put it in a little medley, and closed it out with Unforgettable. And always the response has been absolutely ridiculous.
Unforgettable.
The voices just blended, you know. So the biggest technical thing was just to get all the scratchiness out of the song. Mm-hmm. So what we had to do was just try to get that orchestra, as you know, try to clean up that track as much as possible so that we could just isolate his voice. And then they sampled it so that he could answer me on the second part, which kind of gave the song a little different feel to it. And then the sax solo, which scared me half to death because I thought everyone was going to go, oh, a sax solo, ew, you know. But, you know, it turned out to be okay.
Critics say it's more than okay. And recently, other tributes have been paid to the man, Nat King Cole, and his music. New York Mayor David Dinkins proclaimed February 21st Nat King Cole Day and named a street for him. That afternoon, Natalie donated $100,000 to help preserve the Apollo Theater and gave a benefit concert there later that night.
When you were a child and you sang with your father, which you did many times, you sang to him more than he sang to you.
Because I saw how my father would react when I'd sing to him. He really liked it. Yeah. And it was his chance to be entertained. And to be entertained by his kids, oh, that was the best.
Isn't that,
you know,
something?
And what I ended up doing with him and, you know, my sister as well, is that we would sing back to him things that he had, you know, either turned us on to, or, you know, like the day that I remember so well of me, you know, saying, Dad, I want you to hear the song I learned. And it was an Ella Fitzgerald song. So he was like, oh, yes, she's learning.
Unforgettable.